When a tiger cub begins to be hunted by wolves, a fearful dog must join forces with other animals to defeat an entire pack. Today we're going to recap the story of the movie, The Secret Life of Pets 2, from 2019. In an amusement park, a Jack Russell Terrier called Max watches the children playing with the other animals and talks to his friends about how bad it must be to have such a small human in the house. As her tutor has always been single, Max never thought it would happen, but soon after Katie meets and falls in love with Chuck, a cyclist. Sometime later, the two move in together and Katie ends up getting pregnant, giving birth to little Liam. Even though Max doesn't like children, he has to learn to deal with them and they soon become best friends, with Liam learning to act like a dog. Because of this, Max forms a special bond with Liam and becomes overprotective, getting an itch every time the boy does something he thinks is dangerous. Downstairs, a rabbit plays with his guardian and thinks he's a real superhero, calling himself Captain Snowball. While pretending to be saving the city on the balcony, the rabbit is spotted by Max, who starts talking about his kid. Snowball then asks if Liam is ready to go to school and Max starts to worry, saying that the boy should stay in the apartment safely. While they're talking, Duke shows up and tells them that Chuck has taken Liam for a walk, which worries Max. Wanting to know where he is, the terrier asks his friends for help and the guinea pig Norman decides to answer the call, using a remote control cart to follow them. Through the radio, Norman communicates with Max and warns him that Liam is eating a cookie, but even though it's something common, the dog is still worried and has another itchy crisis. Realizing this, Katie goes to them and asks Max out for a walk, which makes him very happy, but only until he realizes that they are going to the vet. As the dog doesn't want to go, Katie tells him that he's been very stressed lately and forces him into the clinic, where they sit down to wait for his turn to be seen. While they wait, another cat strikes up a conversation with Max and explains that this vet specializes in behavioral disorders, making him realize how crazy the other animals in the clinic are. When he returns home, Max is forced to wear a cone on his head so that he doesn't scratch himself. But because of this, he now loses mobility and can't play with his favorite object, the little bee. While he's trying to get the toy, Duke arrives excited and tells him that he heard Chuck say they were going on a trip, which makes Max very happy. With this information, the terrier takes his little bee and tries to give it to Chloe to look after, but the cat doesn't pay attention to anything he says and Max decides to leave it with another animal. In the apartment below, the dog meets Gidget, a Pomeranian Lulu with whom he leaves the toy. As she is in love with Max, Gidget sees the little bee as if it were their child and promises to look after it with the utmost care. Now that he's found someone to keep the toy, Max and his family get in the car and travel together until they reach a farm. While her beloved gets to know the new place, Gidget is imagining her married life with Max and ends up getting careless, letting the little bee slip onto the balcony. Through the fire exit, the toy bounces down the floors until it lands on the window of another apartment. Desperate, Gidget goes there and realizes that the place is the home of an old woman who lives alone, but just when she is confident that she will be able to retrieve the object, a cat comes out from under the armchair and starts interacting with the toy. When she hears the sound the little bee makes, the other kittens also become interested and hundreds of cats show up vying for the toy, leaving Gidget with no hope of getting it back. A few floors up, Chloe and Snowball are passing the time when a Shih Tzu called Daisy appears at the window wanting to know if they know the building's superhero. Obviously Snowball confirms and asks what she needs, discovering that Daisy has found another helpless animal that needs rescuing. Excited about the mission, the rabbit runs to his room and puts on his costume, jumping down the corridor until he arrives back at Daisy. As soon as she saw the hero, the Shih Tzu said she was playing in the luggage compartment of an airplane when she heard a strange noise. On approaching, the female finds a cage covered by a circus tarpaulin and decides to remove the cover, finding a white tiger cub called Hu completely chained up. Despite not understanding the language of wild animals, Daisy realized that Hu needed help, especially after seeing the circus owner kicking his cage for no reason. Like a good superhero, Captain Snowball doesn't even think twice and accepts the mission, setting off with the Shih Tzu towards the park. At the farm, Dookie gets excited by the smell of the animals and starts running wild around the place, but unlike him, Max feels out of place and can't wait to get home. While on their way back to the family, the dogs end up meeting a turkey who is chasing Max all over the farm. Watching from inside a wrecked car, Gallo, the farm's border collie, gives a bark that puts everything in order, causing the turkey to back off. After the scare, Max becomes even more overprotective and refuses to leave Liam's side. Realizing how stressed his friend is, Duke decides to ask him to play and they both start hunting fireflies. Being a city dog, Max is not used to the taste of insects and decides to go to the nearest bowl to drink water. Seeing this, Rooster growls and approaches him to throw him out, saying that this bowl belongs to him. Wanting to avoid confusion, the two apologize and start talking to the border collie. Realizing that Liam is in a cage, Rooster asks why and Max replies that he could run off and get hurt, but the bigger dog disagrees with this overprotection and says that they should let Liam explore, leaving soon after. In the park, Snowball and Daisy approach the circus and start looking for the white tiger. Suddenly, they hear the sound of whipping and find the circus owner trying to force Hu to jump off a trampoline into a pool of water. As the tiger is afraid of heights, Sergei threatens him with the whip, which only serves to frighten Hu even more. Realizing that the cub is not going to cooperate, Sergei pushes him into the water and his employees immobilize the poor thing, taking the tiger back to his cage. After locking Hu up, the man begins to threaten him and says that if he doesn't learn the trick by the next day, he will be turned into a rug. Angrily, Sergei orders his wolves to keep an eye on the tiger and puts the key to the cage on the post next to them, then goes to bed. As soon as the human walks away, Daisy approaches to console him and the wolves order her to stay away. Obviously, the Shih Tzu refuses and the wolves try to attack her, but as they are chained, they can't reach her. At that moment, Daisy sees where the key is and decides to go after the wolves, making them wrap themselves around the pole as she approaches. Trying to grab it, the leader of the wolves sees Snowball hitting the padlock with a toy sledgehammer and gives it a few tugs, managing to loosen the stake that holds his chain. Finally free, the wolf runs through the park trying to snatch the rabbit, but the stake ends up getting stuck in the seats of the turbo drop. Taking advantage of the gap, Daisy hooks the wolf with her belt and activates the machine, making it go up and down several times. With the way clear, the Shih Tzu returns to the cage and unlocks Hu, leading him towards the apartment. At the farm, Max wakes up and goes to the window to check if Liam is alright, but ends up being seen and attacked by a fox. Frightened, the terrier starts to back away and gets trapped against a rock, but before anything worse can happen, Rooster appears and attacks the wild animal, making it back away and saving Max once again. At the apartment, Gidget decides to go to Chloe and asks for her help to learn how to act like a cat, even going so far as to wear a tiara with cat ears. Now that she's dressed up, Chloe starts her lessons and teaches her to resist the urge to chase after the ball. On the streets, Daisy begins to think about where they can leave Hu, and Snowball has the idea of leaving the tiger cub with Pops, a basset hound who is responsible for educating the babies in the building. Despite this, Pops is startled by Hu and sets off the alarm horn, scaring the little white tiger that sticks to the ceiling. After Hu destroys part of his house, Pops says he can't look after him and asks Snowball to take him, but the other puppies beg him to let the tiger stay and Basset gives in, agreeing to look after the tiger for one night. At the circus, Sergei finds out that Hu has been taken away and starts fighting with the wolves. During the scolding, he realizes that Daisy has dropped the hair ornament and gives it to his animals to sniff out, giving them the mission of bringing the tiger back. Unaware of the risk her friends are taking, Gidget begins her rescue mission and goes to the cat's apartment, managing to get in without the old woman realizing she's a dog. Even though she was scared, Gidget went among the kittens and started looking for the little bee, locating the object on top of the scratching post. Despite being a Pomeranian, Gidget climbs into the toy and finds the little bee underneath a gigantic cat. As he is sleeping, Gidget approaches him, trying to make as little noise as possible, but the sound of her own bee wakes him up. Desperate, the dog asks for help and Norman uses the laser to distract the cat, making it jump off the scratching post and take the bee with it. Furious, the other cats start climbing towards Gidget and she decides to resort to Plan B, enlisting Norman's help to pretend she can catch the point of light. Seeing the dog eating the red light, the cats go into shock and see Gidget as the chosen one, bowing down to their new queen. At the farm, Dookie and Max are watching Rooster herding the oxen when a pig gets loose. Not knowing what to do, Duke suggests calling the border collie and Max refuses, because he's jealous and wants to prove that he can do it too. Even without training, the Jack Russell Terrier tries to lead the piglet into the fence, but not only does he fail, he also breaks the sheep enclosure, releasing all of them. As soon as he sees the animals running away, Rooster appears and manages to take almost all of them back to the fence, with the exception of a baby called Cotton. Since it was Max's fault, Rooster asks for his help and together they go into the woods to find the sheep. After crossing a stream and a bush full of thorns, the two arrive on a very steep hill. Even with difficulty, the town dog manages to climb up and they continue after Cotton, finding him eating apples from a tree in the middle of the cliff. Seeing where he is, Rooster tells him that the tree can't support his weight and that Max is the one who has to get the sheep. Terrified, the terrier refuses and Rooster has to calm him down, telling him that the first step to overcoming fear is to pretend it doesn't exist. Thanks to the border collie's tip, Max manages to gather his courage and starts down the cliff, almost slipping several times. Just as he's about to reach the cotton tree, The rocks begin to give way and Max ends up going straight over, having to climb up to reach the sheep. As he gets closer, the dog asks the sheep to come closer and he says that his leg is caught in the branches, forcing the city dog to climb the tree trunk to rescue him. As soon as he does this, the roots start to come loose and Max has to hold on to the trunk to keep from falling. With the tree about to give way, the town dog runs towards the sheep baby and manages to grab it by the tail, pulling until it loosens its hoof. At the last second, Max throws Cotton over the cliff and jumps off after him, struggling not to slip. Even with difficulty, the dog manages to lift the sheep until Rooster manages to pull it out of the rough terrain. Just after saving Cotton, one of the stones on Max's feet gives way and he almost falls, only to be rescued by Rooster at the last second. After the scare, the two dogs return to the farm and leave the last sheep in the pen, continuing their routines as if nothing had happened. In the city, the wolves continue to follow Daisy's scent and find her telling the story of the rescue to other dogs. As soon as she notices the presence of the wild animals, the Shih Tzu starts running out of the park and tries to hide under another, larger dog. Despite this, the wolves manage to find her using their nose and Daisy has to jump on a human scooter to escape. In the apartment, Snowball is playing video games when Pops appears at the window to return Hu, saying that he has destroyed his apartment and eaten the television. Not knowing what to do, the rabbit takes the tiger to Katie's apartment and leaves it sleeping on Max's bed, but as he's leaving the place, he ends up being caught by Gidget. Confused, the dog asks what he's doing and the rabbit wonders why the cats are behind her. But neither of them has the courage to answer and they end up dropping the subject. At the farm, Max sees Rooster going to his car and decides to follow him, thanking him for the tips and saying that he's calmer now. As he's leaving the next day, the town dog starts to say goodbye when Gallo interrupts with a howl. Confused, Max asks if he wants to be left alone and the sheepdog replies that this is common on the farm, asking if he wants to try it too. Together, the two spend the night howling and Rooster decides to give Max his scarf as a present, making the town dog go away feeling even more confident. Back home, Max arrives at the apartment and goes to bed with Liam. Taking advantage of the family being asleep, Snowball tries to sneak Hu out of the apartment unnoticed, but Max wakes up and catches the tiger. Confused, the dog asks what's going on and Daisy replies that she doesn't have time to explain, as the wolves will be there soon. At this point, the female realizes that the animals are already out and the rabbit starts freaking out, thinking that they're all going to be eaten. On the other hand, Max is very different and doesn't think twice before going down to confront them. Even alone against four, the dog tries to frighten the wolves, but Sergei appears behind him and kicks him into the basement of a house. While the dog tries to climb back up, the other animals go out onto the terrace and Snowball tries to take on Sergei's monkey, but is easily defeated. Just then, the wolves also arrive on the terrace and the circus owner hits Hu with a tranquilizer dart, causing him to black out. To defend her friend, Daisy even tries to bite Sergei's leg, but it's too small and she can't do anything but get captured along with the tiger. When Max finally manages to get out of the cellar, Sergei puts Hu back in his cage and starts driving back to the circus. To rescue their friends, Max and Captain Snowball use Norman's cart to chase the humans. As they drive, the rabbit calls for reinforcements and Gidget answers, gathering her army of cats. To help, they make the old lady think she's run out of food so that she can drive to the market, taking advantage of the fact that the old lady is almost blind to move the steering wheel without her noticing. Not realizing that an army of cats is coming, Sergei takes Hu out of his cage and puts him on the train, threatening him with a stun gun. As soon as the locomotive leaves, Max and the others arrive with the cart and drive along the track behind them, but the rough terrain ends up breaking it and they have to continue on foot. As the train is still accelerating, Max manages to jump in and catch the snowball with his mouth, leaving Norman behind. Over the radio, the guinea pig tells them they're on the train and Gidget passes on the instructions to the cats. Walking on top of the locomotive, Snowball ends up falling into a wagon where he finds Daisy trapped inside a cannon. On top of the train, Max offers to help them when the wolves appear behind him, forcing him to move forward to try to escape. Inside the wagon, Snowball approaches to help Daisy, but ends up being surprised by the monkey who throws some kanais in his direction. Extremely ninja, the rabbit manages to dodge all of them and throws the last one back at the primate, hitting his scarf which gets stuck in a piece of wood. As the enemy can't move, Snowball runs towards him and hits a kick that knocks the wood over, forming an arena on the ground. Now that there's a ring, the two begin to face each other directly and the rabbit hits a combo of kicks to the monkey's face as well as punches right into his belly. With the monkey seemingly defenseless, Captain Snowball approaches to finish him off and ends up being surprised by a blow from his staff. On top of the train, Max runs through the wagons and manages to knock down one of the wolves, as well as making the other two slide out of the locomotive with the help of some tubes. Inside the wagon, the monkey sets fire to some torches and takes the opportunity to light the fuse of the cannon, forcing Snowball to stop his attack to save Daisy. Not realizing that the Shih Tzu has managed to get out of the cannon, Snowball tries to extinguish the fuse when the monkey appears and they start a slapping contest, ending with the rabbit sticking his finger in the primate's eye. Taking advantage of the gap, Daisy turns the cannon and throws the monkey into the barrel, causing it to be hurled skywards. At the front of the locomotive, Max is finally reaching Sergei when he is hit by the monkey, falling off the train along with him. While the primate is passed out, Max gets up and starts running through the forest, cutting a path and ending up on top of the tunnel where the train will pass. After a few seconds of waiting, the locomotive approaches and Max jumps into the first carriage, rolling down the windshield and biting into Sergei's lower body. While the human is writhing in pain, Snowball jumps on his face and the two animals manage to knock him down. Thinking they've won, the animals start taking Hu away, but Sergei gets up and pulls the tiger's chain, drawing his revolver to finish them off. At that moment, Granny arrives with the cats and rushes at the villain, as well as backing over him to confirm that she has managed to get him out of circulation. Now that everyone is well, Grandma takes the animals back home and adopts Hu, thinking he's just another kitten. In the other apartments, everyone goes back to their routine and Liam starts school, but unlike before, Max is no longer afraid and wants the boy to see the world. So what did you think of this movie? Leave it in the comments below. And if you like the video, like and subscribe for more movie recaps. See you next time.